significant breaking news tonight. I want to go straight out front now to the Republican senator from Idaho, of course, which votes tomorrow, James Risch. He has endorsed Marco Rubio for president. Senator Risch, you heard Jamie Gangel's reporting that there has been conversations within the Rubio campaign about whether he should drop out before the Florida primary. What do you think?
Erin, you know, this really isn't fair. With all due respect to you and to Jamie and to CNN, who I respect tremendously, this really is not fair. Look, I was with the campaign this weekend. Indeed, yesterday I traveled with the campaign and we did a number of events with the senator. In addition to that, I am, as you know, a senior surrogate for the campaign. Yes. I sat at the table with the advisors, including the senior advisors to the campaign. I can tell you there was not even a hint that that was the issue. Indeed, we had deep and lengthy discussions about Florida, the strategy there, how they're going forward in Florida, and the good things that are happening in Florida, which you didn't mention, and that is that he's closed a 20-point gap down to 8 in a very short period of time. We all know he's a great closer. He's going to win Florida, and he's going to be in it. This really, you know, to repeat a rumor like this without having foundation and naming the person who is supposed to be putting this out really just isn't fair, because these rumors get started and people repeat them.
Okay, I'm going to sit here as the anchor of the show, stand by CNN's reporting. This has been vetted through our political desk. They are going with the story. But Senator, let me ask you, because you raise a narrowing of the gap in Florida. That is one way to put it. Of course, there's one poll, a Quinnipiac poll, had Donald Trump ahead by, 16 or 18 points? A Monmouth poll today, 8 points. So it's two different polls. Really shouldn't compare them, but if you want to call that narrowing, certainly go ahead and do so. There's still the question, though, as to why Marco Rubio is not polling ahead in Florida. Why isn't he?
Well, he is, actually. You're comparing those polls to ones that had him 20 or better points behind less than a week ago. We all saw what happened in Virginia. It was the exact same way. He closed that gap and came very close. If Kasich hadn't been in a race, he'd have won Virginia. But look, I understand that you stand by your reporting, but I'm telling you, I was there. I was sitting at the table. We had lengthy discussions about the various states and how we were going to go forward and about what's happening in Florida. And not one person made even a hint that this wasn't going to happen. And there is no reluctance, and there isn't this isn't going on. Now, I don't know who your source is, but I can tell you they weren't sitting at that table, or they're not telling you the truth.
So let me ask you, Senator, about his chances in Florida, because you talk about that he's gained. Okay, he's gained, but he's still not ahead in the polls. Donald Trump is still ahead and outside the margin of error. Today, a major Florida paper, the Sun Sentinel, which endorsed Rubio when he ran for Senate, right? So they were predisposed to like him, chose not to endorse any GOP candidate this time around. Their reasoning on Rubio was, and I'll quote, "Remember that he has done almost no experience and has done little but run for office. Then when he gets in office, he doesn't go to work very much. He holds the worst attendance record in the U.S. Senate." Senator, as a fellow senator, how do you respond to that? That's a pretty damning summary.
Look, I've spent hundreds of hours with Marco Rubio over recent years on national security issues. We both sit on the Foreign Relations Committee. We both sit on the Intelligence Committee. Whoever wrote that and says that he doesn't know what he's doing, or he's incompetent or inexperienced, does not know what they're talking about. He and I have gone head-to-head over and over and over again on dozens of occasions with the administration on their foreign policy and on their intelligence initiatives. This guy is ready to be president, not on the first day, but on today.
All right. Thank you very much, Senator. I appreciate
it.
And passion defense of the man that you were here to defend. And I thank